evening, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for coming to our presentation tonight. Today, we would like to talk about the fascinating nature of Japanese garden. I'm Sayaka. These are my co-presenter, Nana and Enna. The Japanese garden has been familiar to many people through the ages. The time Japanese spend at the garden makes us relax and think about ourselves internally.
First, Nana will introduce long and rich history of Japanese gardens. Next, Sayaka will talk about unique objects in Japanese gardens. Finally, I'll introduce the majestic tradition, the three great gardens of Japan. Please enjoy our presentation.
Thank you, Anna. Good evening, I'm Nana. I'd like to show you long and rich history of Japanese gardens. Have you ever been to Japanese gardens? Japan has traditional and culture that is Japanese gardens. Japanese gardens, which have long and rich history stretching over 11 historical periods. I will introduce three topics: beginning, Middle Ages, and modern times. Let's start with the beginning. First of all, I tell you about Asuka and Nara period. It was from 592 to 794. In 645 is start of Japanese gardens. Japanese garden were introduced from China. Japanese garden has basic structure such as pond, sand, and waterfall. The oldest garden is in Nara, its name Heijokyo. Next is Heian period. It was from 794 to 1185. This period was starting point and basic philosophies. Japanese garden were introduced from temple for ceremony and banquet. They use yarimis. Yarimis is they built pond and floated a boat, and also they ran water. It's like a river. The fourth period is Kamakura period. It was from 1185 to 1333. The people made small and simple gardens because to see from the buildings, and they found a way to enjoy the gardens. For example, walked around the garden and looked at the garden from the buildings. The famous place is Tenryu Temple in Kyoto. Let's move on to Middle Ages. During Muromachi period, it was from 1336 to 1573. Japanese garden style changed. They used kare sansui that didn't use water. They expressed water with stone and sand, so they could make Japanese gardens without water. The famous place is Ryuan Temple in Kyoto. This style has continued in the future. Next is Azuchi Momoyama period. It was from 1573 to 1603. The people proved authority that were built large-scale gardens. Japanese gardens were made in front of tea room, and they used tobi-ishi and chozubachi. Tobi-ishi is big stone on the moss, and chozubachi is container to save the water. The seventh period is Edo period. It was from 1603 to 1868. Japanese gardens were made by not only shogun and daimyo, but also ordinary people. They use a lot of flowers, such as plum tree and cherry tree. Let's move on to modern times. During Meiji period, it was from 1868 to 1912. Japanese garden was shaped by introduction of Western style. They use pond with glass, so they introduce Western style and Japanese style. Next is Taisho and Showa period. It was from 1912 to 1986. Japanese gardens are made use of natural landscape and environment. They tried large-scale garden, natural scenery style, and the Association of Japanese Gardens was established in 1990. The association researched old garden and new Japanese garden style. Today, Japanese garden observe modern Japanese garden style. Japanese garden are made on the roof of building. It's called roof garden. They use artificial turf. Japanese garden are made from not only regular style, but also new Japanese garden style, such as space and function. In conclusion, I talked about beginning, introduced from China. Middle Ages, they introduced a lot of styles. And last is modern times for Western style and new Japanese garden style. Japanese garden has long history and 11 period has a lot of styles. We can enjoy to see Japanese gardens and it is a good culture. Thank you for listening. Next, Sayaka will talk about unique object in Japanese gardens.
Thank you, Nana, for sharing us long and rich history of Japanese garden. Good evening again. I'm Sayaka. Today, I'd like to talk about unique object in Japanese garden. Do you know how many objects Japanese garden consists of? You learn Japanese garden has a long history. Meanwhile, people created new styles, designs, and objects, and also took in new objects from China. First, I'd like to talk about vegetation types, and then I'll explain about stone types and the water types. Let's start looking at vegetation type. The various plants have auspicious meaning in Japan. They are called engi no ii plants in Japanese. They are a sign for luck or good omen. Hori is prevention of crime and talisman in Japan. Because hori has a thorn, so it protects from bad things. Bay tree is symbol of victory and glory, so it is given to a winner and excellent person. Japanese garden has many supporting plants. These plants cannot be main parts, but they are necessary for Japanese garden. Bamboo is one of the supporting plants, and also it is great materials. In Japanese garden, bamboo is used for shishiodoshi, which means scared deer. A holy bamboo branch fills with water from fountain, and then suddenly tips, making a knocking sound that scared animals. Let's watch this short video. Japan has seasonal plants. Cherry blossom is famous for spring seasons. Hydrangea is famous for rainy seasons. Maple trees are famous for fall seasons. Let's move on to the next topic. Next, I'd like to talk about stone types. Japanese garden has many kinds of stone structures. Tsurushima, Kameshima are one of the stone structures. Tsuru means crane. Kame means turtle. Shima means island. These express long life because the crane and turtle symbolize long life in Japan. Next is pass. Pass is not only to lead visitor to the best visitor of Japanese garden, but also to influence how the visitor experiences the garden. Stepping stone is one of the pass types. They called tobiishi in Japanese. The visitor have to jump to go one stone to another stones. Next is lantern. Lantern is called toro in Japanese. Lantern is from China. In Japan, lantern are originally used only temple and also it is lined and illuminated paths. And then people started to use in shrines, and also it is changed on appreciation purpose. Let's move on to the water types. Water is necessary for traditional Japanese garden. Almost all Japanese garden has a pond, island, and bridges. Pond represent imaginary sea or lakes. It is a central element of Japanese garden. Island represent artificial island, which can be created in pond, such as mountain island and rocky island. Bridges were used to connect island across stream or pond. It first appeared in Japanese garden during Heian period. Japanese garden has a stream. Streams are related to feng shui. Stream has legend. The water have to enter the garden from east, flow toward the west. Water flowing east to west will carry evil. It's said by feng shui. Finally, Japanese garden has a water basins. There are two types. They call tsukubai and chozubachi in Japanese. Chozubachi is model of tsukubai. It can be found at entrance of garden, temple, and shrines, because visitors purify themselves by rituals, often provided with small scoop of water. In conclusion, Japanese garden has a three type of important object. Vegetation types have auspicious meaning and many kinds of seasonal plants. Stone types can influence how the visitor experiences the garden. Water types is based on traditional Japanese garden. I recommend you go to Manito Park in Spokane. You can find many objects. Thank you for listening. Next, Anna will talk about majestic tradition, the three great gardens of Japan.
Thank you, Sayaka, for sharing unique objects in Japanese gardens. Good evening again. I'm Anna. Before I start my presentation, let me ask one question. What is a garden for you? Thank you. You probably enjoy growing vegetables, flowers, and playing with your children in their garden. In Japan, some people have their own yards in their houses, and some temples and shrines also have gardens on site. Gardens are one of essential elements for Japanese. There are an officially designated gardens, but they are especially beautiful and famous gardens, which are called the Three Great Gardens of Japan. Today, I'll introduce three gardens. First, Kenrokuen. Next, Korakuen. The last is Kairakuen. Let's start with the first garden, Kenrokuen Garden. This garden is located in Ishikawa Prefecture. An area is 27 acres. The name Kenrokuen means Garden of Six Sublimities. M means garden in Japanese. Kenrokuen has six elements: spaciousness, seclusion, artificiality, antiquity, abundant water, and broad views. This garden was constructed by Tsunanori Maeda in 1676. At first, this garden was used for banquet, such as gazing at the moon. In 1759, most of the garden was burnt down because of a big fire. Reconstruction and rearrangement was started 15 years later. Kenrokuen was opened to public in 1874 and was selected scenic beauty sites. There are outstanding spots to enjoy this garden very much. Kotoji stone lantern has two legs. One is 2 meters, the other is 80 centimeters. Originally, these two legs were the same length, but the other one was broken for some reason. In addition, Yukizuri is also important structure. It means snow hanging and keeps branches from breaking because of heavy snow. Visitors can enjoy different looks by seasons, such as cherry blossoms in spring, maple trees in autumn, and so on. My next topic is Kōrakuen Garden. This garden is located in Okayama Prefecture. An area is 32 acres large. The meaning of the name is seeking pleasure only after dealing with difficulties. A head of a feudal lord, whose name is Tsunamasa Ikeda, constructed this garden for his families and followers to relax. Kōrakuen suffered damage from a flood and bombing, but this garden was restored based on a pictorial diagram. Kōrakuen is Kaiyu-style garden. Kaiyu means strolling. Visitors can enjoy wandering through this garden. This garden is also borrowed scenery style. This is a specific technique to make a dynamic landscape by borrowing nature view into a garden. In this case, a castle, which is called Okayama Castle, is located next to this garden. So the garden borrows this castle view. Let's move on to the final garden, Kairakuen Garden. This garden is located in Ibaraki Prefecture. An area is 740 acres large. After Central Park in New York, this is the second largest land all over the world. The meaning of the name is garden for everyone's pleasure. Ninth feudal lord of this area, Nariaki Tokugawa, constructed this garden. Many changes were arranged and the site was expanded gradually. In 1999, the plan to expand the site from 540 acres to 740 acres large was officially announced. Finally, this garden was completed in 2011. Next, I'll tell about the structure. Kōbunte is a historic wooden building. Nariaki, who constructed this garden, held parties and events to entertain everyone. Kōdōkan is also a characteristic area. People learned history, mathematics, riding horses, and so on in this facility. There are over 3,000 plum trees in 100 varieties in this garden. In February and March, Plum Blossom Festival and Yoru Ume Matsuri are held every year. During Yoru Ume Matsuri, visitors can enjoy viewing plum trees with candles on display for only one night. In conclusion, we can enjoy different looks by seasons in Kenrokuen Garden. Kōrakuen is borrowed scenery style. There are over 3,000 plum trees in Kairakuen Garden. If you visit them, you must be impressed by the beauty. We should leave the cultural traditions to the next generations. Thank you for listening.
Today, we talked about these topics. There are a long history, a lot of objects, and a famous place. As you can see, Japanese garden are one of Japanese culture and traditional. If you go to Japanese gardens, you can get a great peace of mind. Thank you for listening.